Agora vai. Um, dois, três. Welcome to my channel. My name is Roboy, and today we're gonna have a closer look at the new Rodecaster Pro 2. But this time it's not gonna be on the device. It's gonna be on the Rode Central. As you can see on the screen right here, firmware is 1.0.0, and we have audio setup. If I press here, it's gonna be every single channel and the virtual channel as well. On the bottom here, you're able to switch and change the positions. Let's say the virtual channels, in our case, is gonna be up here. My audio main is my pod mic over here, channel one. But if I wanna use this via virtual channel, I can just drag this channel one on my virtual channel tab here. And now automatically it's gonna change on my Rodecaster Pro 2. It's like super quick. And now the USB-C, it's here. If you wanna bring it back, you can just drop there. It will customize automatically. If we click here in every single channel, not the virtual one, because we're not able to see the colors. Here is just the six main channels. We are able to customize the color, and it's gonna change super quick, automatically. Boom. If I choose this one, it's gonna be blue, pink, perfect. And you can do that with every single channel that you have. This is the first section, audio setup. Device configuration. Here we have a lot of stuff. Don't get me wrong, we are able to do everything here using the Rodecaster Pro 2, but this video is mainly showing how to use on the Rode Central, okay? Output, we have headphones, which in my case, I always use my NTH-100 for my main channel, channel one. Channel two, with my friend Dario, that we record the in-depth video from the Rodecaster Pro 2 the other day. He was using a low sensitivity one, so we had to use this setting over here, and it was perfect. It worked amazing. For the monitor, we have auto mute output and fixed output levels. And on listen, we have pre-fader listen and after fader listen. If we select this, doesn't really matter. The main channel is gonna be able to listen everything. If you wanna adjust the audio or if you're live streaming, podcast, whatever, you can listen first, try it out, and then bring it up before people are able to listen. And if you press after fader listen, doesn't matter what you do or listen or adjust, everyone is gonna be able to listen with you, okay? Multi-track, this is one of my favorite features because we are able to save in one single track, or you are able to save a multi-track, which in this case is gonna be every single channel that you have. You will be able to customize, change the volume, adapt, use later in the post-production. So this way you have way more ability and flexibility to edit every single channel that you want. If you mess up on my channel 6 here, this music is playing. If I don't really want to use that track behind or was too loud when I was speaking, I can just bring on my editing software later and I'm just able to bring this volume down, or I can just not use that section and I'm gonna be able to add later. So this is an amazing feature, multi-track, and you're always gonna have a full track with everything on it. So you don't need to worry about it. I always recommend to use the post fader. As we know, post fader, everything that you adjust with the faders, it will be recognized and it will be saved, okay? And the same thing you are able to do via USB. Here we have processing, master compeller, or output delay. Here is the main master from Apex system that we are able to customize and bring the best quality possible. And here on the other section, we have display. On the display section, we will be able to customize the brightness, which here you can do automatic. The display section here, if I move this right or left, we will be able to see that we will be able to change the brightening of the display, the touch screen. And the buttons, the same thing. Here is this headphone ones. And then this one is the whole pad section. I don't recommend to put too high, because if you press something, you're not gonna be able to see which one is active, only on the screen. So I always like to keep this a little bit lower, and now we can see the difference when it's on or when it's off. Perfect. And you can control them after 30 seconds, 1 minute, 5 minutes, 15 minutes, 30 minutes, or never. I just leave this on never. Now we have the mirroring. This is what I highly, highly recommend for you to use, because this way we don't even need headphones to make sure that our audio levels are amazing and are not picking pod mic here on my channel one. I know that my audio is picking kind of in the perfect range, which is -6 for me, okay? So I can see here, because I allowed the broadcast display. If I press default, all the screens gonna go back to zero as a default, and you're not gonna be able to see the levels. They do give lines here, but if you wanna be even more precise, I like this a lot and I highly recommend. Haptics, this is the haptics feedback. It's a very fun feature, because here is just feedback on hold. And if I press haptic feedback always on, when I click here, you can hear that do a little vibration. And in the next session, we have system. System here, we have MIDI control, which is basically a language that you're able to communicate between your Rodecaster Pro 2 in your computer or any other device that has MIDI. Everything that has MIDI on, you're able to adjust and control here as well. Information, this is information about your Rodecaster. Networks, the same thing. Let's go back. Now here we have customized smart pads. This is one of amazing feature as well. If I press continue here, it will activate transfer mode. We are able to control every single section of the smart pad, which is amazing. We are able to add effects, sounds. We can trigger fade in, fade out, MIDI, as we talked before, change our voice. We can create, add, and customize every single smart pad that we have here. In the total is 64. In this case here, a music, we have applause, we have crickets, a bunch of different effects that they already include here. If I go to section 2, this is the one that I customized. Pitch up, monster, megaphone, large robot, small robot, different effects as well. And here, for example, if I click here, we will be able to see the session here. And if I move this, the smart pad will change the color automatically. So very nice to customize. And you can do that with everything that you have here. If you press clear, trash talk, I press clear, it will ask you to clear the pad, and this section will not have anything, and it's gonna be like this, no color, okay? But if you create your own audio, like in my section here, you'll be able to change if it's hold, if it's gonna be a one shot, if it's gonna be a toggle, if it's gonna be a loop on or loop off, replay, continue, all this good stuff. And you're able to export to your computer as well if you press here. Or even better, if you have this empty section, if you click there, you are able to drag and drop any sound effect that you have on your computer. If you have an intro, if you have an outro, if you have any sound effects that you like to use on your videos, podcasts, live streaming, gaming, music, whatever you want, you're able to use here on the Rodecaster Pro 2 right away, right after you drag there. And you are able to rename over here, effect 001. You are able to change the color, like I said before, effect yellow, boom, 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 it's here, okay? If you see that you have this effect section that we add from our Rodecaster Pro 2, we are not able to adjust or change, okay? But if it's something that you created, we are able to do that. And this was the smart pad section. Now we have the transfer recordings, which is an amazing feature that I like a lot. We're gonna activate transfer mode again. This way I have a micro SD card here, automatically it will recognize. As you can see here, this is all the recordings that I did. If you press here, it will select all of them and you are able to export all of them together. Amazing. Or if you don't want to select any, just press none and you can select individually. If you just want to select by categories or by different sections, as you can see here, this audio is multi-track. That is only 4 seconds that I was testing. This one's a stereo track, 13 minutes for my videos. Sometimes I like to record just stereo, just one take Drake and link to my video and done. Here, basically when you click the audio here, you see that you're able to change the name and the color as well. So if I select this to blue and then I go here, I can select by color. So all the reds is gonna be here, all the blues gonna be here. So that's another different way that you can look for your audio. Let's say the red is gonna be my YouTube videos, the blue is gonna be my podcast, and the yellow is gonna be my videocast. If I press minus here or plus, we are able to see closer and we are able to listen right away or track. Pause, and you can go back 15 or 30 seconds. And another nice thing is, if I click here, you see that it will show these marks. Every time that you're using your Rodecaster Pro 2, when you press record, it will show there. Touch the time or touch the screen to add a marker. So later, if you bring here on your Rodecaster Pro 2 and you wanna listen right away after you record, and then here, let's say if you have a podcast, you record everything here, you don't wanna edit, don't need to edit anything because you have intro, outro effects, you talk to your guests, you interview via Bluetooth because your friend was far away. You have everything done. Perfect. So now you're gonna post to Spotify, you just click there, boom, export, and it will give you that perfect quality for that specific place they wanna post it. In my case here, I'm gonna go to custom and then we can customize the format MP3 or WAV. Amazing as well. I like to leave it WAV. Export, and then you have your file right on your computer. Very easy, very fast. This way you speed up your workflow, so you can just drag and drop on your folder that you want to start editing, sync to your video, and you're ready to go. Thank you very much for watching this video. Leave your like, this way you're gonna be able to support me a lot. Leave your comment down below. I would like to know, what do you think about the Rode Central and the Rodecaster Pro 2? If you want to keep learning about this amazing device, I have another video here for you. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next video.